Today on Animal Fact Files, we're discussing feather duster worms. Feather duster worms are annelids, meaning they are segmented worms like earthworms and leeches. They range in size from under an inch to over a foot in length. Smaller species have fewer than a dozen segments, while larger species can have hundreds. These segments are typically divided into a torso and an abdomen based on their function. Feather duster worms also have a head from which their plume of feathers extends. Just to be clear, these aren't actually feathers. The only known living animals to possess feathers are birds. Feather duster worms are also known as the flowers of the sea. They come in all kinds of colors and can be found living in marine waters throughout the world. They are most common in intertidal and coastal reef areas, but they've also been observed in the deep ocean. They're not restricted to just saltwater either. Some feather duster worm species have been found living in freshwater places. These invertebrates are also known as fan worms and tube worms. These common names can be a little confusing because they're also applied to other similar-looking animals, like Christmas tree worms. The difference between the feather duster worms we're discussing in this video and the worms that share a family with Christmas tree worms is that Christmas tree worms and their family members have an operculum, or lid, for closing up their tube. The feather duster worms in this video don't possess that operculum. A feather duster worm's body is encased in a tube that is made using their own mucus mixed with sand and other debris. There are some that build their tubes out of calcium carbonate as well. A feather duster worm's tube is flexible and longer than its body, so it can shrink into the tube to hide from predators. Predators to these worms include crustaceans, sea urchins, and fish, which may nip at their plumes. Thankfully, these can be regrown if lost. These tentacles act like gills, as well as food collectors. Like sea pens, feather duster worms capture planktonic food particles on their feather-like projections. These are waved through the water to capture food, though some species may also hang over their tube and grab food from the sea floor. Their plumes are also used for obtaining oxygen from the surrounding water. When they're in danger, feather duster worms can retract quickly into their tube to avoid threats. Like scallops, they have eyes, or at least eye spots, that detect light. When threatened, they swiftly disappear. In some species, the tube may also be used for egg brooding. Feather duster worms appear in separate sexes or as hermaphrodites. They most commonly reproduce sexually, via broadcast spawning, where eggs are fertilized externally. These worms often settle near each other and create colonies that release their gametes all at the same time. Others lay eggs in gelatinous masses that remain in or just outside the tube until they hatch. Feather duster worm larvae float throughout the water until they develop more and then settle to the bottom of the water column. It may take up to 2 years for them to reach adulthood, and most only live a few years. However, more research is needed in this area. For more facts on feather duster worms, check out the links below. Give a thumbs up if you learned something new today. Thank you to our patrons, SpikeSpiegel93, Dad, and everyone else for their support of this channel. And thank you for watching Animal Fact Files.